Hi, my name is Parker Toddy, and I'm an avid 12 student. I live in a community where there is an even split of whites and Hispanics, and the school I attend mirrors the community perfectly. I wish I could say that we live as one in the community, and no separation or discrimination exists. However, that is not the case. Although our community has made strides in the right direction, the Latinos and whites are still very separate. I grew up in a white neighborhood, which consequently meant that my friends were white and that I associated with very few Latinos. I was just another white kid living a good life in the suburbs and had no outlook or awareness of anything going on around me in the community. Being admitted into AVID was not originally my choice. My high school football coach strongly encouraged me to be in the program because he believed that just as he was my coach to teach me about football and fitness, my AVID teacher would be my coach to teach me about academics and college. On the first day of AVID freshman year, I looked around and saw a very slim amount of familiar faces. When I looked around, I saw 4 white kids and 28 Latino kids. It was the first time in my life when I was the minority. I found myself making my way towards the white students because that is what I felt most comfortable with. At first, I wanted to drop out of the AVID program because I felt that it was not going to be beneficial to me. That was until I received my second progress report in the first semester of my freshman year. Before I even had the chance to see my grades, my coaches and parents had already begun yelling at me about how disappointed they were in me. My biggest supporter through this time was my AVID teacher, Mrs. Griffin. Instead of yelling at me, she guided me to communicate with my teachers and utilized tutorials more to help me with my grades. Through tutorials, I found my second family, my AVID brothers and sisters. It took a while for the racial barriers to be broken down, but once they were, if it were not for our looks, you would not be able to tell us apart. Becoming close friends with people from all sorts of different socioeconomic and cultural backgrounds did not happen overnight. After numerous Hug It Out Fridays, where we would have to hug at least 15 of our AVID classmates, and many forced fun conversations, where we'd be randomly selected to talk to an AVID classmate for 5 minutes, I made friends. Friends that have impacted my life and influenced me to stay on the right academic path through making sure I have my TRFs in on time, all my Cornell notes ready to turn in, and to make sure my grades were where they need to be. Living in such a divided community, I would have never seen the other side if it were not for AVID. My worldview has been expanded, and I met many lifelong friends that I would not have met without AVID. If only our community, and even our world, could take the same family approach to life that AVID takes, we would be living in a more peaceful and united community. One thing I would like you to learn from me is that there is no look to AVID. Do not judge or make decisions based on appearance and stereotypes. My AVID sister Alondra, who came to the U.S. in the 5th grade, knowing no English, is AVID. My AVID brother John, who is extremely shy but broke out of his shell because of the comfort he felt to speak up in our tutorials, is AVID. My AVID brother Gerardo, who will not only be the first in his family to attend college, but also graduate high school, is AVID. And I, Parker Toddy, a white kid who has lived a very blessed life but needed some extra academic help and to open his eyes to people different than himself, am AVID. So to everyone who has helped me along the way, especially my AVID brothers and sisters, thank you.
Show on, get